yesterday, the chairman of the party and one other person who calls himself the leader of the party, one Akogunbanji Ojo, decided to go and merge with PDP in respect of the governorship election of July 14th, claiming that Abiodun Aluko is not ready for the election. The Director General of our organization, Dr. S. Ogunniyi, is here to read our position paper on the matter.
Our attention has been drawn to the press release by Akol Chairman of the state that our principal, Sophia Dodan, has not been up and doing in his campaign activities towards the July 14, 2019 governorship election. Nothing can be further from the truth. On becoming the candidate of Accord on the 29th of May 2018, we discovered that, apart from the state secretariat and a handful of some people based at Abuja, posting as state officers, most of whom have no political base, and there are no structure of Accord in most of the local governments and wards. It was Sophia Adoyaro who started building the structures. The same chairman and the so-called leader of the party, one Akogunbanji Ojo, demanded 65 million from our principal. As money they allegedly spent on the party before he became the flag bearer, we saw Abiodun could not see evidence on ground, and he believed such money should be used to establish structures in all the 16 local government areas of the state and the 177 wards. That was the source of the disagreement.
One man who calls himself the leader of the party said he had spent 65,750,000 naira in putting Accord in place before I came, and he said I must refund the money at all costs. This is the letter of demand, official letter of demand that he wrote to me. And I reported the case to the national leadership of the party. We went to Abuja, and Abuja said, no, it's not right. You can't claim to have spent this amount of money, and you could not even become the candidate of the party. He had run away back to Europe when he was broke and they had no money. One Mrs. Ilesame was the candidate who stepped down for me, and not Akogun. That's the woman. That you can see, one Mrs. Margaret Ilesame was the candidate of Accord before I came in, who stepped down for me, not even Akogun. But because of my status as former deputy governor, they all believed that I have billions of naira. So that's why they came up with this letter of demand. And when we got to Abuja and I explained everything to them, they said, okay, we should go and resolve. I, on my own, for peace to reign, opted to even give Akogun 5 million just to allow peace to reign. He refused. He said he was taking nothing less than 65.75 million naira from me. And I said, no, I can't pay. I would rather use that money to develop the party and fund my campaign than to give it to an individual, when I even discovered that Accord had no structures on ground by the time I came. They were able to get a willing buyer in the state governor. They went to sell themselves to him, and he readily paid them off. And they were on EKTV this morning making all sorts of allegations, wild allegations that were not true, just to justify the money they collected from Fayose. So, as far as I am concerned, I've already informed the national leadership of the party, and the national leadership of the party had already met and had taken a position on them to sanction them. Tomorrow, you will see the position of the national leadership of Accord in all the newspapers. We had already gone around some of the local governments, right from Ekiti East down to Ikere, and the reception was very interesting, exciting. So if there is any question you want to ask any gray area, please, you are free to. But the bottom line is that these people, they are political, they are political harlots. They are out to make money out of the system and nothing more. And they believe that they got somebody who they can suck. A former deputy governor who they believe has a minting machine at home that they can suck and get the best out of him. So that's the official letter that I've given to you of demand. This is the first time in my political history that I will see a person who is not the chairman of the party, who is not the candidate of the party that stepped down for me, making a demand and being at the jugular of the state chairman and pushing him around, saying that unless I pay the money, they will not support my candidacy. So this is the basic line, bottom line, and this is why I've called the press to let you know that as far as I'm concerned, apart from being immodest or arrogant, I think I'm capable to be the president of this country, not just the governor of the state. Yes, the chairman of Bonny, you are here.
Yes, sir.
The chairman of Ado, you are here.
Yes, sir.
The chairman of Ikere, you are here.
Yes.
The chairman of Oye, you are here.
Yes.
Which other chairman is here?
Mama
is here. They are all here. Record of Felodu, they are all here. So they have not gone with anybody in the first instance. They had nobody before I came in. Other than that state secretariat, which was Akogun's campaign office. And by the time we came, 4 out of the 10 officers of the party were from Irekwodu Feludu alone. The PRO, the state secretary, the state woman leader, and one other officer from one local government out of 16. Ikere local government, nobody. Ado local government, nobody. So they are claiming that that's a party that has a statewide spread. It's when I came that I was able to put all these people in place, all the chairmen. You get what I'm saying? So in from local government where the chairman comes from, I'm saying that they had no chairman there. When I wanted to do the flag off, that when I was coming with the flag from Omo down to Ikere, we sent a bus to Efon to go and pick 20 members of the party to join our train. They were there for over 5 hours. They could not fill the bus with 20 people of Accord. So where are the people that they say they have taken to PDP? They have only gone to Dupe Fayose. That's just the basic truth.